I did have an epiphany about relationships. I was so sick of myself asking that question of people in couples. How did you guys meet? Did your hands come together by accident in a garden? What do people always say? They always say something like, we met and we got to know each other. And we really liked each other. And, there's ups and downs, but we still really like each other. So we stay together. Oh, I'm sorry if you're bored with your miracle! It seems like it's an impossible combination. Like, you gotta want it, but not want to be available. No, I'm busy. He's the one, but that's a deal breaker. It's like, the odds of falling in love with the right person at the right time seem to be about the odds of being discovered in Hollywood. Wait a minute. I asked a similarly question for many, a desperate question for many years now, which was, I used to ask it, which was, how do you make it in show business? Do you move to San Diego and disguise yourself as a bush? Now, what do famous people always say? They always say, do you enjoy doing it? That's all there is. You just keep doing it. You just keep doing it. You get better and better. Pretty soon you look at, oh my gosh, I've been doing this a long time. You get to do it. It's a privilege. And, there's no guarantees. But the great thing is that, you can just keep doing it. And good luck. Good luck. Which is profoundly true. Is that what a relationship is? Is it just showing up? I didn't realize I'd have the ambiguity and doubt as much as there is in a job. Because people always say, once you've been doing it for a long time, I bet you always wanted to be, whatever it is, a comedian. I did not want to do this show tonight. And that means me and my pickle, my chicken leg, we've got a chance, because we've had our high times, Oh God, we're so good at kissing. Our kissing should be on TV. Then you get into the craftsmanship stage, and that's when I get a poor attitude, Like in this job where I say, I want to be a comic, but I don't want to have to go to a sports bar, where the Raisin Bran Bowl is playing and nobody's listening. Well, Princess Daffodil, that would be the whole fucking thing. So why don't you learn to enunciate above 9 television sets? Make some friends. And if you're lucky in life, you get to have those dark times. The relationship equivalent of 2 weeks in Laughlin, Nevada, bombing 3 shows a night for hundreds of silent, angry jet skiers. Laughing and crying, thinking, this is not at all what I wanted. But there is one strawberry toaster pastry left in that hallway of a vending machine, and you make it through another show. And that way you get to nights like tonight, where it all seems like it was meant to be.